Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about all the short questions given in our NCERT book, which is for second chapter, Principles of Management. Okay, we will understand how we can write the answer, how we can frame the answers, as well as how we can get the good marks in our questions, and what the questions come in exam, then how we can write those answers. First, begin with how is the principle of unity of command useful to the management. Now, as we are in general nature, we write the direct the use of unity of command. But before writing any answer, you need to write what do you mean by unity of command, and then write what is its use. So let's discuss what is its main definition or what is the meaning of unity of command. Unity of command is generally deals with an individual have following direction of a single boss. He must follow only and only single boss. He can't get the directions or he can't get the controls or orders from the multiple superiors. This is the objective of the unity of command. So, the principle of unity of command states that any person should be answerable to just one boss. If an individual receives command from two or more people, then this principle is violated, as in employee getting confused. According to Fayol, this principle plays an important role in employee, which leads to instability and disturbance. For example, suppose a sales manager gives B a task that has to be completed in 5 days. On the other hand, C, a finance manager, asks B to complete the same task in 3 days. This will lead to confusion in terms of targets, as in we don't know how to complete and when to complete the time, as in sales manager asked to do the time to do the target within 5 days, but the finance manager asked to do the same task within the 3 days. So the person who is doing the job gets confused that I need to follow whose rules and regulations, whom guidelines. Okay, that's the principle of unity of command. Next question. Explain the principles of scientific management given by Taylor. Yeah guys, remember Taylor given us our 4 principles of scientific management. Let us remember what are they 4. See, you need to learn all these 4 by name. Yeah, science. Not rule of thumb. He gave 4 principles. Let's discuss all about this. First was that science, not rule of thumb. What does that mean? He told that all the principles of management are generally science. That is, they are based on experiments as well as experiences and observations. They are observed on the basis of workers, different workers, different timings, different resources. They are observed and utilized and managed. But they aren't rule of thumb. Rule of thumb means they are not generally applicable to each and every organization. They will be applicable only to the specialized situations, not at the everywhere, not at the universal situation. Okay, so first was that science, not rule of thumb. Yeah, second, harmony, not discord. What does that mean in our principles? Harmony, not discord means that all the workers and management staff should be coordinated timely, should be do work in a coordination manner. They have to be maintain a coordination so that they will doing the work on a simultaneous basis. They won't be keep conflicted, they won't get the conflicted, or they won't get be affected. Okay. Next was cooperation, not individualism. This was the extension of harmony, not discord. As in, whenever you guys doing the work in a team, you are doing the task, then you need cooperation. You can't be think about yourself only, and you can't be decide about that this work should be done by me only. You should appreciate the work to others also, to your team members also, to your junior staff also. And the last but not least, personal development. Personal development means it is not the personal development. Guys, see the difference. There is a personal development. It is not a personal development. What is the difference? पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट इज ऑलवेज टॉक अबाउट योर इंडिविजुअल इंटरेस्ट ओनली, योर इंडिविजुअल डेवलपमेंट ओनली, बट पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट टॉक्स अबाउट दैट यू नीड टू डेवलप योर एम्प्लॉयज, यू नीड टू प्रोवाइड दैम ट्रेनिंग, यू नीड टू प्रोवाइड दैम एजुकेशन टू डू द टास्क इन अ बेटर मैनर, एज वेल एज द एजुकेशन और ट्रेनिंग यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग टू एनी वर्कर शुड बी गिवन टू ईच एंड एवरी एम्प्लॉय और एवरी वर्कर. इट कांट बी बेस्ड ऑन द सिंगल पर्टिकुलर पर्सन और सिंगल वर्कर only, it should be given to each kind of worker so that my objects or targets are achieved on time as well as they know the objective of the organization. It helps to achieve the organization of also it helps to achieve objectives of organization. Clear my friends? Next, yeah, science not a rule of thumb, harmony not discord, you need to explain all of them. Cooperation, not individualism, and personal development. Now, let's see our next question. Define scientific management, state any three principles. Same question repeated again. Okay, next. Explain the following principles of management given by Fayol with the examples. Now, you need to explain all these kind of principles with the examples. Let's discuss each and every principle with their example. First of all, unity of direction. In unity of direction, we had learned about that you should direct a work and you should direct each and every part segment. You should divide your work in each and every segment or department, as well as you need a particular person who can direct that particular department or segment. Like in case of companies, आपको परचेज डिपार्टमेंट, सेल्स डिपार्टमेंट, मार्केटिंग डिपार्टमेंट अलग करना पड़ेगा और उसके लिए उसमें आपको एक सीनियर रखना पड़ेगा जिसको आप बोलोगे परचेज मैनेजर, सेल्स मैनेजर, प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर एक्सेट्रा, फाइनेंस मैनेजर एक्सेट्रा. अब इस मैनेजर की ड्यूटी क्या रहेगी कि वो अपना डिपार्टमेंट की सारी रूल्स एंड रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज और अथॉरिटीज को डिजाइन करे कि उसको कहाँ पर कैसे क्या काम करना है और कैसे क्या काम करवाना है. ये सारी रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज उनके इंडिविजुअल रेस्पेक्टिव मैनेजर्स के ऊपर रहेगी. This objective should be applicable in MNCs, big organizations. This can't be applicable on the lower level organizations. Clear, my friends? Next is equity. Principle of equity. What do you mean by principle of equity? Principle of equity told about that equal opportunities should be given to each and every employee, each and every worker. It can't be differentiated between sex, caste, religion, nationalism, etc. You need to promote or you need to provide each and every opportunities to each and every individual. As in, you can't say we will hire only the Maheshwaris in our company, only the Jains in our company, only the Muslims in our company, only the Sikhs are in our company. You can't say that. In case of giving the best opportunities, you have to allow all kind of persons, all kind of employees, human beings into your organization to take part and give their best. Next is esprit de corps. Esprit de corps means, we had learned about that, esprit de corps talks about teamwork done by management and worker, that all the work should be done by in a team, as well as all the work should be appreciated and management has the quality that he will be appreciate work of every each and every his individual, his seniors, his juniors, as well as he will appreciate them in a public and give them reward in a public. But in case they got a failure, then management blame himself or herself just because his employer, his worker can't get suffered and he will be motivated with the efforts done by manager. Next is order. What do you mean by the principle of order? Principle of order told about that each and everything should be placed at a particular place. As in, each and every person, each and every raw material should be placed at a particular place which is required to give a best efforts or best targets which can be achieved. Like any person who is having a commercial background or who is having a chartered accountant or who is having a company secretary, he or she must be put or must be recruited at the post of finance background or law background or commerce background of the company only. He can't be used or he can't be recruited at the place of technician's place, as in he is not able to understand what kind of softwares or hardwares we are using. He can't be able to repair the hardwares or softwares. So he can't be put or recruited at the technician level. It also applies on vice versa. You can't tell that technician need to do work of finance jobs. No, my dear friends, they can't do. It's same like that in case of production also, raw materials also. Raw materials should be placed at the required place only. As in, for example, in case of big marts, D-marts, Reliance, Geomart, Walmart, whatever the big supermarket you had given, gone through, they required that the specified particular department, that this segment requires only food stuff, this segment requires the cosmetics, this segment requires the chocolate department. So you need to understand that where which product should be placed and when. Clear? Next, centralization and decentralization. What do you mean by centralization and decentralization principle? Centralization principle generally talks about that all the guidelines, all the directions should be given by a single person and followed by many person. As in, ek hi boss hai, wahi direction de raha hai aur sare employees usi ko follow kar rahe hai. But in case of decentralization, and centralization also applies on top level management. But in case of decentralization mein generally coordination hota hai, cooperation hota hai, middle level aur lower level management ke saath dealing hoti hai. As well as यहाँ पर एक सिर्फ सिंगल बॉस का कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं होता, यहाँ पर मल्टीपल बॉसेस होते हैं, मल्टीपल उनमें कोऑर्डिनेशन होता है और मल्टीपल बॉसेस के डिसीजंस और स्ट्रेटजीज को फॉलो करना पड़ता है. क्लियर माय फ्रेंड्स? नेक्स्ट, इनिशिएटिव. व्हाट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनिशिएटिव? दैट मैनेजमेंट शुड आस्क देयर एम्प्लॉयज और वर्कर्स अबाउट सजेशंस. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सजेशंस कंपनी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू डू? They should take participate, they should allow to participate their employees so that their employees will feel get motivated and appreciated that our manager kind of person is asking about the suggestion or reviews, what I think is best thing. So you must do the initiative skill to your workers as well as employees as well as your team members too, to provide some suggestions or initiations which can give us a best utilization of resources as well as it will give our targets achieved on time, effective and efficient manner also. Clear? Next, if the organization does not provide the right place for physical and human resources in an organization, which principle is violated? Does not provide the right place for physical and human resources. Means they are violated the principle of order, my friends. In case of principle of order, the things or principle in or person should be ordered or placed at a particular place or at a particular time or at a regular interval, I must say. So they violated the principle of order. Next, explain any 4 points regarding significance of principles of management. What are the significance of principles of management? In case of principles of management, we need to discuss that why we require this kind of principle, why it is required to manage all kind of principles of management. First one was insights to reality. That is, it faces to this all kind of principles, dealt with the real situations, real experiences. So all these situations dealt with the real life, your management, real life helpful, real life experiences, real life experiments, it should be dealt with like that only. That these kind of principles should be applicable in each and every organization. Somehow they are applicable in any manner, whether they can be modifiedly managed or whether they can be managed as such given by them. But these are should be managed or implemented in each and every organization. Next, logistic decisions. Significance of principles of management helps to take logistic decisions. Logistic decisions means decisions management has to take that their target should be achieved on time or not, as well as what kind of resources they are required to manage, to utilize, and how to utilize your resources. Next is basic education of management. principals also provide that managers need to be knowledgeable, experienced and skillable, qualified, so that they can give their best efforts as compared to the unqualified managers and inexperienced managers. Then optimal use of resources, the main thing in case of significance of principle of management, resources should be utilized in an optimum manner. This is the main source. So that whenever you're, what is the meaning of optimum utilization? That resources should be used in an effective and efficient manner. Clear? Next, explain the principle of scalar chain and gangplank. Yeah, in scalar chain, we had discussed about that all the information should be communicated and coordinated with their senior staff, as well as all kind of seniors must have knowledge about what are their junior staff thinking about and what they are doing the work. We already discussed this in a diagram also. See the diagram. Here, if a C wants to communicate to D, or C wants to communicate to E, or to B, or to A, then he must need that C need to first tell to B, B need to tell A that C wants to this. If he wants to communicate with D, then A will tell D, and if C will communicate with E, then D will tell E about what C wants to do work with you. But in case of emergencies, we have already learned about, in case of emergencies, if same level employees have to deal with themselves, that is B with the D and C with the E, they can deal with the help of gangplank, a particular line which helps them to deal with the same level employees on the basis, on the situation of emergencies only. Clear? Next, management should find one best way to perform a task. One best way. Which technique of scientific management is defined in this statement? Time study deals with at what time you need to complete your production. Or it shows accuracy, that whether you made production in an accurate manner or not. Motion study deals with movement of your production. Movement or speed. Fatigue study deals with tiredness of worker, or rest or idle time of worker. And the method study deals with, it tells about any work should be done in how it can be done, what method or what technique we can use to done a job. It tells about how any task is required to be done. So let's see the question. Management should find one best way to perform a task. What is the best study in this? Time? No. Motion? No. Fatigue? No. But method? Yes. You need to take decision on the basis of one best way, on the basis of method study. Next, which of the following statements best describe mental revolution? Okay, what does that mental revolution mean? It means that it requires change of attitude in between management and workers, as they decide all the work should be done by all, not only the one person only. The credit can't be given to only single person, it should be given to each and every employee. So, it implies change of attitude, yes. The management and workers should not play the game of one-upmanship, no. Both management and workers require each other, yeah, we can tell this also. Workers should be paid more wages. Workers should be paid more wages if they observed or if they maintain standard production. Okay, but what is the answer? Because this is MCQ. which of the following statement best describes mental revolution, which is the bestly described. Best described means which is the best among these three, because this is not the solution, so don't remember this, but these three are suitable to mental revolution, but which is best for this. Best was only for this, that is change of attitude. It requires change of attitude of employees as well as managers. Next, which of the following statement is false about Taylor and Fayol? Okay, let's see. Fayol was a mining engineer, whereas Taylor was a mechanical engineer. Yeah, this is true. Fayol's principles are applicable in specialized situations, whereas Taylor's principles have universal application. No, my dear, this is false, because what's the correct statement is Fayol's principles are Fayol's principles are universally applicable. And Taylor's principles are applicable on specialized situations only. So the condition stated here is vice versa. Now see the next statement. Fayol's principles were formed through personal experiences, and whereas Taylor's principles were formed through experimentation. This is true, my friends. Then Fayol's principles are applicable at the top level of management, and Taylor's principles are applicable at the shop level management. This is also true. So what's our answer is that Fayol's principles are applicable in specialized. Instead, it should be written as universally applicable, whereas Taylor's principles have universal application. Instead, they should be written as specialized situations. Clear? Okay, thank you.